I really love the facility here and the environment. It's such a beautiful city. This year, as an Olympic year, it's going to be a little different. It's really the great preparation going into Rio. It's the best of the best, so it's great to see where everybody's at. So when we go back home, we work harder, so it's exciting.
What have your impressions been of sport, and more specifically swimming and diving over here in the region?
It's so impressive. Every year we see so many divers. There's a little diving show in between the finals every year, and every year there's more and more and more divers. It's just great that a World Series, a competition like that, can bloom out a diving club like this. It's incredible.
How much more pressure do you feel going into an event like this, knowing that August is coming up very, very fast?
Well, there's a little bit more pressure, of course. We want to have a great year, a great preparation. We want to show to the judges that are going to be in Rio what we have, what we're capable of. So it's everything counts right now. So it's exciting, and we want to give that performance and show everybody what we've got.
Being an Olympic year, does that change or affect much your approach or training?
Olympic year doesn't change very much our approach. I've organized everything from London 2012 to Rio 2016. So the plan was to go year by year, and I'm following my plan. It's going great. I had a little incident at the beginning of the year. I broke my ankle. So World Series in Dubai, in Beijing, was my first competition since that injury, my first World Series. So I'm really excited to compete again and see the evolution of my diving again.
Well, while you were getting into the sport, were there any role models or heroes that athletes you looked up to while you were coming through?
Well, for sure. I started because of a Canadian diver, Annie Pelletier, who won the bronze medal on 3 meter in the 96 Atlanta Olympic Games. When I saw her, I immediately wanted to become just like her. So my parents put me into diving, and I've been diving for 20 years now.
What is like a typical day for you training-wise?
Well, for me, back in Montreal, Canada, we start training at 10 a.m. and we go all day till 4:30 p.m. There's a mix of dry land training, a lot of water training. Two times during the week, we take a break of an hour and a half to go do weights at a gym with our physical trainers. We do a little bit of yoga, stretching to make sure everything is in place. It's a really full-time job, so it is important to take care of yourself.
How important do you feel like it is for you to try to be, one of the faces of diving and kind of promote the sport?
For sure. I'm excited to be up front just to get our sport out there, to talk about diving. In the Olympics, everybody watches it and they love it. It's in the top sport to be watched. So it is important to get people involved and to get people to try out. And it's such a complete and beautiful sport.